Said El Harrak is a boxing sensation right here at the Goosen Gym in Van Nuys. He's training with Joe Goosen, and we caught up with him. Check it out.
See, Ellie, why you keep up like that? You're getting a little damn.
You know what? That's called invading someone's personal space.
Depends on what country you are. I took sociology classes.
No, I know which country I'm in.
Yeah. We're not in New England like Tyson Fury getting a
3,000-pound fine for talking smack?
He's getting fined because he was hyping up one of his fights, right?
No, where's he was talking smack about David Price and his mother.
Oh, wait a minute. Where is that?
England.
So obviously they don't have freedom of speech.
I guess not.
You know what? I feel bad for them. Hey, better back off. We got a guy from England right here.
I thought he was talking smack about the Queen or something. Huh?
You from England, Sid?
Hold on, let him take off his earmuffs.
Yeah. You're from England?
Jumpy now.
You're from England?
Yeah. We were just talking about Tyson Fury getting fined for, using his freedom of speech, and we just
£3,000.
It's like $5,000, right?
Yeah.
Now. Yeah.
You look like Lamont Peterson.
I get everybody. I get Kenyon Martin, all that stuff.
Yeah, you do.
He looks like Saeed Harrak to me, but it's 11-2. It should be 11-1, but it's 11-2 with 8 knockouts.
I fought across my last fight. They gave him a split decision.
Which tells us
I fought him in Tucson, Arizona. And it was just on Azteca Network, Spanish commentator and stuff. They gave him two judges scoring for him, and one had a shutout for me. So this is the way boxing is. You know?
Where are you from in England?
London.
Really?
Yeah, East London.
Ah, I've been there.
Yeah,
it's a third world country, East London.
Yeah, it feels like a third world country, you know?
My first day there, someone offered to sell me cocaine. I was barely like getting off the tram.
Well, you don't have to go to England for that to happen.
The last time I was in London, it was in a market, pure daylight, and a lady was just walking, and a guy ran by and stole her handbag and took off. She fell on the ground. He had like 20 people chasing her. It's crazy. Yeah.
You know the bridge,
why,
gym?
Why? They wanted what was inside the purse?
They just walked.
No,
they're just
kidding.
Okay, find out from your parents.
What gyms are in East LA, the boxing gyms?
I'm not really.
East LA?
East London.
Yeah.
I know there's a gym in
Repton?
Yeah, Repton, that's the gym.
Yeah.
I went there a couple of times, but I mean, I've lived here since I was 13 years
okay.
old. But my family live in England, so I go back.
It used to be a bathhouse and they turned it into a gym.
Yeah, I've been there.
Well, yeah, at least after you work out, you can take a bath.
No, they got rid of the bath.
Yeah,
I get it, Ellie.
That's a very popular gym in England. Though.
It is.
Yeah, my cousins used to go there, so.
Mm-hmm. Just a little bit south of Nottingham.
Yeah.
So, what do you think about David Hay?
David Haye.
Watch what you say, you might get fined.
He became a world champion, you know, so you gotta respect anyone that's fulfilled their dream.
Okay.
You're gonna have nothing bad to say about him. You know?
What about Amir Khan?
Amir Khan, I like Amir Khan, you know, but he still has a lot to learn. Like, he doesn't know how to fight on the inside yet. He fights in a straight line, you know what I'm saying? Like, everyone has something to learn, you know? Everyone has something to improve on, you know? It's just that how far he came on his natural talent and ability from the amateurs, and with some guys, that's just not gonna cut it, you know? So, I believe that if he perfects a few little things, he could do a little more, he could do better, you know?
What about Carl Froch?
Carl Froch? I like Carl Froch, like, he's a stand-up guy. When he lost to Andre Ward, he admitted that Andre was just the better man that night, you know?
And you appreciated that?
Yeah, you gotta respect people like that, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people can't do that, they make excuses. And he wants a rematch with Andre, I heard, like after the Kessler fight, so you gotta respect that too, because he wants to go back there, because he got shut out by Andre pretty much.
So how did you end up in this gym out of every gym in the world?
Oh, I work literally a mile from here, so. And then I wanted to come train with Joe for like a little while here, a little time, but I was always moving, always in different places. So now I work over here, and I was like, it's so convenient, it's up the road. And I came in here, and Joe was gracious enough to take me on, so now I'm here.
Joe, what weight class is he fighting?
Sid can fight at 54 or 47. We'll eventually get him down back to 47.
He's very tall if he's going to fight 47. You'll be the tallest 47 in the world.
No, I fought a 40-pounder that was 6'5", my pro debut. I don't know how he made 40, but he was 6'5", literally.
Maybe he hangs out with Nicole Richie. Joe, what can you tell us about Sid?
Oh, Sid's a great fighter. Look, I mean, here's the thing. I'm, you know, it was like I was just telling Andre Berto, was asking me about it, and he said, what type of style is he? He said he's a boxer, puncher. He's very savvy in the ring. He's got a lot of real intelligent moves. He's very accurate. And of course, on the downside, and this happens, like you said, he moves around a little bit. He was here, he was there. Sometimes you need a home base, and you need that real 6 days a week work. And that's where we're getting now. And I think us together with what I'm going to bring to Sid and what he already brings to the table with his great talent, get him in the right shape, add a few details to the mix here, shore up a few things, add a lot more endurance, and you know what? He's going to be almost impossible to beat.
I heard about you. You're Moroccan, right?
Yeah.
I know. You were 11-0 at some point, right?
No.
11-1?
9-0.
He's Moroccan and rolling.
Yes. No, and you were training people at some point too, right? Were you a little bit?
Yeah, just
messing around with it.
Yeah. I love boxing, like, and I believe, like, cause I was moving around so much, I was out of the gym training myself. I believe the only way you can stay sharp mentally in the sport is actually take someone and teach them the fundamentals, so you remind yourself. You're like, oh wow, you know, I forgot to do this. So, I mean, I always try to perfect my craft because you always know more. You always learn more. Like Bernard Hopkins, he can always be better than what he is, you know, and that's why he's been the game so long, because he's never leveled up. He's always trying to improve.
The Moroccan Olympic teams in boxing would always do good back in the day.
Yeah, back in the day, not now.
Now.
I was in the camp for the Moroccan Olympic team camp, and it's more of cardio they're teaching. Like, they're in shape. Like, one thing, they're in shape. They can run.
They can do DVDs and get people in shape. But
yeah, they're in shape. Like, the camp was good. Like, for conditioning-wise, I was in great shape. The food and everything, nutrition and all that was really good. But fundamentally, we don't have the coaches out there. You know, we just don't have
Joe?
Well, hopefully we have a coach here. But let me just tell you something.
Yeah.
Aside from all that, Sid is a very, very talented guy. All he needs is a fight that'll get some notice, have him win it, and he'll be on his way.
Another 47.
You know, I'm not going to mess around with somebody that I don't think is going to be able to move forward. And I really believe in Sid. I really do. And every day that passes, the more I work with him, the better shape he gets in, the more I can see the handwriting on the wall that the future's going to hold. So I'm very very confident in his skills. And us working together, I think it's going to be a winning combat.
There you have it. Stay tuned. Any message to your friends back home in England, your family?
I'm just going to do my best. That's what I'm gonna do.
47. Would you want to fight Mayweather if it came up?
Like, I'm not even close to even to be talking about someone like that. So I want to pay my dues before I even say anybody like that. You know, I don't need to beat, like Joe said, to beat a credible opponent and beat a few of them. Even he's not.
Very humble. Everybody else would say yeah.
Well, that's not only humble. It's realistic.
I'm not even thinking about that. Next week, I'm playing too far ahead, then you just, like, you end up getting lost on the track. You know, I'm going to stay on the next one first.
There you have it. Stay tuned right here at Goose and Jimmy Van Nuys, facebookreport.com. I'm Melissa Quack reporting.